So we were fueled by wine, so that might have been part of
it. It was biodynamic.
Yeah, tell us about that wine that you ordered.
I can't remember the name. Like, it was a...
You know it was good wine when you can't remember what you had.
It was clutching.
Alcohol causes a release of gamma-aminobutyric acid, so you get an inhibitory neurotransmitter release. But the problem is when you overdo alcohol, it tends to wear off very early in the night, which is why you wake up at like 1 or 2 a.m. after you've had
parched
multiple drinks, and then you can't get back to sleep. But this idea of drinking wine that uses microfiltration, that gets rid of a lot of the sulfites that comes from typically grapes that weren't grown with herbicides. It's an old world wine method. Like, I know you, Dan, you drink dry farm wines.
Yeah, absolutely.
By the way, we're having a wine party at our event.
Oh, tonight?
No, Atlanta.
Oh, in Atlanta. Okay, yeah. Stay tuned for more about the Atlanta event. We'll
fill
you guys in on that.
We're going to have a wine party, just so you know.
It's going to be
dry
nuts.
Dry farm wines.
Anyways, though, so whenever I'm at a restaurant, I'm going to order the wine. Then I'll look for the organic. But the other thing to really look for, if you want to sound like a smart cookie, but also go way above and beyond organic, which we did last night, is you ask for biodynamic, because organic wines aren't necessarily filtering out like the sulfites and some of the stuff that give you headaches or that disrupt your sleep cycles that you were talking about. Whereas with biodynamic wine, you're drinking very, very clean.
Yeah,
clean.
It's amazing.
So biodynamic is actually better than organic.
And most biodynamic wines are organic.
That's what I was saying.
But biodynamic is typically better than organic.
See, I didn't know that.
Yeah, because a lot of these old world biodynamic wineries, they're organic just by nature. That's just what they do. They're that into the quality of the wines they aren't spraying.
People listening and watching, there's 76 additives allowed in wine.
Yeah.
And it's not tested for. It doesn't have to be on the label. Even the organic wines, especially ones from Napa, which we love going to Napa, they're finding glyphosate in it, which is a chemical that causes holes in the gut, leaky gut, and even holes, which I call leaky brain. So, I mean, this stuff's nasty. It's driving autoimmune and a lot of unexplainable illnesses.